Welcome to Dano on Fire right here on Hi TV. I'm at Ekote Japanese Restaurant and Bar. This brilliant restaurant is located at the Dutch Hospital. Now, when you come here, you don't want to come alone. You want to come with someone who enjoys food. She made a career out of it. She is one of the biggest social media influencers in Sri Lanka. Not only that, she's a wonderful girl with stunning looks to go with it. I'm happy to have Christina Plate as my date for today, right here on Dano on Fire. Welcome to Dano on Fire right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel made possible by our friends at LICC. Thank you so very much for joining me. Today on the show, I have someone who is simply gorgeous, as I told you. She is absolutely stunning at any given time. Christina. Well, she's known as Christina Plate to all those. Yeah. How did this Plate name come about?
Okay, so my real name is Christina Pires. So my friend at AOD, when I moved back from Abu Dhabi, they used to call me, oh, Pires here. So which meant Plate.
I was going to say, yeah.
Yeah.
So, but Pires is a sauce.
I know, but then somehow it evolved to being Plate. Okay. And then everyone in AOD started calling me Plate. Then Christina Plate, so I changed my Facebook name and it just stuck. And so I had no option to change. Like, no, I couldn't change it after that.
So after that, you just remained as Plate?
I remained as Plate.
Would you ever officially change it to Plate?
No, I mean, Pires is my family name. It's my dad's name and he would kill me if I did.
Like, you went from Pires to Plate?
Yeah, but there's an actual Christina Plate and she's French and an actress.
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
And I actually got this email saying, oh, you're trying to copy her name, and that was not the case. But yeah, that actually.
You should have said Pires in Sinhalese in this. Please get on with the page.
Yeah, should have.
Yeah. So to start things off, mm-hmm. You came into the public eye with being on fashionmarket.lk.
Yes.
This is where we were looking at this girl and everyone was like, who is she? That's when I first saw you and I thought you were absolutely gorgeous. No. I didn't even think you were Sri Lankan to start with.
Ooh.
Did a lot of people think that you were not Sri Lankan?
I mean, I've gotten it a couple of times, but only when I was in Abu Dhabi. But okay. Over here, I mean, I pretty much look
yeah,
Sri Lankan.
You
I mean,
blending well.
Yeah.
But on the website and everything, yeah. I really thought you were like brought down for a shoot or something.
Ooh,
like that.
Oh, okay, that's interesting.
But that was your start, is
that
it?
Was my start, because the owner of Fashion Market was the owner of AOD, Linda.
Yeah.
So after AOD, she was like, hey, would you like to be our brand ambassador? And at the time, I wasn't into modeling. I'm still not.
Yeah,
and
then because I've never seen you on the runway for any show.
No, I'm not into modeling as such, but brand ambassador work, it's something I love to do.
Right.
Yeah. So then Linda was like, would you like to do this for us? And I couldn't say no to her. So I was like, yeah, let's try it out. And it kind of stuck and I enjoy working with them and that helped me out a lot.
Really? Now, just to give you a bit of a rundown of where we are, this like this beautiful restaurant. Mm-hmm. You were here last March, you said.
Yes, I was here for a review, loved it, and I was happy we're coming back here.
I don't want to say the name because I might eat it.
Try it, let's try it. Okay. Try it. You go first.
No, I can't.
No, you go first.
No,
okay,
can't.
I'll say the first one.
Okay.
You go.
That's where the. Say
okay.
No.
Okay, let's say it together.
Okay.
One, two three. Eco. Danu, it's your show. Go on.
Say it for me once, and I'll say it after that.
Can we get some? Can we phone a friend?
Oh no! Why do you think this? Like, I'm not giving you a million. I promise you that.
Tay, I want to say Tay. I don't know.
Pote.
No. No, that's a completely different place. But anyways.
So you were here last March.
Yeah, I was here for a review. Absolutely loved it.
All right, so we are at Ekote. I hope I said it right. This is a fabulous restaurant. Of course, it's looked into by the brilliant hospitality providers in the country, and I think the whole world will agree on Hilton. Mm-hmm. And so we're here to enjoy some brilliant food, and I can't wait to try it. What was your experience like last time?
I loved it. I mean, we were able to try 6 different dishes,
okay.
And we were full by the time, you know, it was done. And we also tried their cocktails are really good. I was telling you about this, but like.
And then she said, mocktails are also very good.
The mocktails are also really, really good.
So we're talking about drinks, I think, cheers to good life.
Cheers, Danu.
There you go.
Yeah, you have to look in the eye when you cheers.
Oh, sorry.
All the time.
All right.
Yeah.
I hope to win a crown too one day.
You already have.
Oh,
it's
thank
invisible.
You. Thank you. Really. Thank you. All right, so tell me about this. You know, see, I don't do food reviews always.
Uh-huh.
But I look like I've eaten the buffet permanently. How do you maintain such slender body?
I think it runs in the family. My parents are both like on the slender side, but then also like the moment I feel like I'm gaining weight, I work out a little bit or something.
You don't work out every day?
No, I used to gym thrice a week, but then I was like, that's not for me. I can't do it. I can't be bothered waking up at 5 in the morning to go to the gym. So I work out at home every day before I like sleep.
Like, what do you do?
Couple of sit-up, crunches, squats.
For just how long?
About 30 minutes.
Life is really unfair, right? You're either just born fat or you're just born
like Christina. No, I don't eat meat, so I think that has helped me a
lot. I also don't eat meat.
Oh my god.
I only eat chicken.
That's meat.
That's the only meat.
Right? On the meat. Yeah, but like I don't. And after I stopped eating meat, I noticed a huge change in my body as well.
Right then. All right. So now this food reviewing, mm-hmm. like you became such a sensation online. Was it after you've left AOD?
Yes, it was after I left AOD and I love food and I love to eat. So me and my friends would go out all the time and we would eat. And I started posting that on Instagram and people would
But how are the pretty pictures always?
I use my phone. Editing, it's all in the editing. Trust me, I'll teach you.
You'll never tell the secrets, I tell you.
No, I'll teach you how to edit. It's all in the editing. And I started posting it on Instagram and people would refer to my Instagram as a blog. And I would be like, you know, I just want to actually like make this more professional, take it to the next level.
Yeah, and you did.
It. I did, yeah. And then in like a week, I told my dad I want to start a blog. He looked at me like, what is a blog? Like, yeah. He was like I'm stupid.
What is this?
What is this? What is this blog you speak of? But like, yeah, I launched it in a week and it's been good ever since.
Yeah, touch wood. Yeah. Or you can just touch me for gold.
Yes.
So the best part about it is, of course, you can follow her. She gives out some great reviews.
Thank you.
You have been to hotels, you have been to... You know, the best part is, you know, I was in a tub once to take pictures at a hotel. They actually didn't want to even see those pictures. They actually returned it back to me. But whereas you were in a jacuzzi, like, and there were like millions of people...
Did you use the pictures? Did you post the pictures?
I posted it.
Good, do it. Yeah. Like...
But, you know, I think it got referred to as a complaint on Instagram.
Thank you.
I'm just joking. All right. Okay. We've got the menu now. See, Ikote.
Yeah, you said it right.
I was perfect.
You're perfect. Yeah.
Brilliant. Now we're going to go through this menu and pick out a few.
I'm going to follow your lead.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah.
I thought you have been here before.
I have been here, anyway, but I like so many. I like everything on the menu.
I'm going to let the main guy make
its
call.
Let's do that. Let's do that.
So we're going to talk more, of course, when we do come back, a little bit about her time as Miss Sri Lanka when she represented us at the Miss Universe pageant and at the same time being ranked as number 16, correct?
Yes.
that's a hard work. Mm-hmm. That's a lot of hard work that sort of brought our country there. We'll speak more, of course, after the break. Do stick around. It's Dhanu on Fire right here on Hi TV. The show, it's Dhanu on Fire right here on Hi TV, and it's made possible by our friends at LICC Jeans. Welcome to the show. As you know, we are in conversation with this beautiful lady, Christina Plate. She also goes as Love Plate.
Yeah.
You can check her out on Instagram, you can check her out on her blog, you can come to know more about her and such a food lover she is. We are going to be pampered and fed by Hikaru.
Hi.
Got your name. All right. So we're at Ikote, this brilliant restaurant that serves some excellent food. So because he said that not everyone gets his name right,
yeah.
So he introduces himself as Hakuru. Hakuru is much better. All right.
It's
yes,
easy.
Definitely. All right. So are you going to do some magic for us?
Yes.
All right. While he's doing the magic, while we dig into this.
Yeah.
Christina, tell me about you winning. Okay, we are going to try this.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not too bad with it, but I'm terrible. I'm terrible. Just try to wing it there.
Okay. So tell me a little about when you went for Miss Universe. Mm-hmm. How was it? Because you never won a pageant. It was...
Yeah, I was nominated and interviewed.
You can go ahead and do what you're doing.
Oh, broke it in one.
Yeah. So you were nominated and...
Yeah, so I was nominated. So we spoke about fashion market earlier.
Yeah.
So Linda sent my profile in, and then I was shortlisted, and I get a phone call one day saying, you know, we want to interview you. And I was like, for what?
For
like,
what? Yeah. What is so the purpose? Like,
yeah, Miss Universe Sri Lanka. So I spoke with my dad immediately first, who is now my manager.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and he was like, you know, give it a go and see, you know, if you like it. Mm. And, you know, that's how it all started, because, I mean, pageants aren't my thing.
Yeah.
And a lot of people were surprised in the beginning, like, what? You're going for Miss Universe? Like, it doesn't make sense. Mm. So see, you're good at it. Let me try this.
It's just the prawn was too good for me to not eat it.
I'm so bad at this.
No, you can get it there. You can.
Yeah.
Let's. So good.
I always do a little down.
Thank you.
So good.
Thank you. Very good. I'm so excited to try this crispy skin. Now this is all I can do. I can't eat this. Ah, okay.
Yeah, you have to like step
it. I did it. Look at me. I'm such a more shows. I think I'll be there. So, this experience of, you have never walked the ramp.
Mm-hmm.
You have never done this whole turn, look three times.
Mm-hmm.
How was it for you to get through to all of that?
So when I was nominated, like I hadn't been on a stage before, I wasn't in front of a large crowd before, other than obviously school concerts and things like that. So when I went to Vegas, where Miss Universe was, Danu, it was like the best experience of my life. Like, to be honest, those are priceless memories, plus all the girls we still keep in contact still up to date.
Up to now. Who is the best friend you made there?
A couple.
Okay.
But I would say New Zealand and Panama are like my best friends there.
And who were you sharing the room with?
India.
Always is India and Sri Lanka together.
Always India. But you know, we are like sisters. We have a love-hate relationship, which is good. And I miss her all the time also. But then when she's there, I'm just like, but like, I miss her too. But like, she's coming to Sri Lanka as well.
Oh, excellent.
But like, back to your question.
Okay.
Yeah. So when I was at Miss Universe and on the stage in front of all these people, I was just like, oh my God. Like, I was freaking out, like, obviously, for the first time. But all I wanted to do was like not fall on stage. Like, that's the only thing I wanted to do. Yeah.
But being ranked as 16 is not easy task. And actually, I was just telling her even before we went into the break, while we were at the break, I was telling her, Sri Lanka has been performing very well at Universe.
Yeah.
We got top 16. We got crowned for Miss Congeniality. These are big things for Sri Lanka.
Yeah.
Because we have been quiet for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
What would you advise to someone who wants to get into beauty pageants? Would you say it's something that you'll do? You won't, I know.
I won't. Like, locally, when it comes to pageants, it's something I do want to stay away from. Like, it's not my thing.
Yeah.
And the experience I had personally wasn't as pleasant. But then if it's someone who wants to get into pageants and wants to get into, like, be Miss Universe Sri Lanka, they should go for it, because the experience you get internationally is just, like I said, priceless, you know?
How was it for you in terms of the support that came your way after winning it? Well, your family, of course, 100%, but organizers-wise.
So there were people like Krishani George, Brian and Kamil, who were constantly there. Krishani, she helped me with fitness, getting ready. But like I said, I told you, I had a month to prepare, which was not enough at all for me. So, but she was there and she was helping me, guiding me. And Kamil was helping me from my wardrobe. He was like, what do you need? You need cocktail dressers, gowns. He was a support system that I needed.
Mm.
And even when I was in Vegas, he would call me and be like, how was today? Did you have fun? And he was the friend I needed throughout the pageant.
And also who understood the trade and what you require.
Exactly.
Because even apparently, like, there are like 100, so many things that you have to take, so many undergarments you have to take. Like, there's a list of
the undergarments,
It's like a list of 100 things, right?
Exactly. And like my roommate, Miss India, like, she opens her bags and everything was packed for her by the organization.
Wow.
Day one, day two, day three, what to wear. And I had like my little clothes that I went shopping with my sister and got. Like, you know, but it was good enough. But the support that other countries have is amazing.
All right. Thank you, Chef.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
This is garlic rice. So
all right.
Please enjoy me.
Brilliant. Thank you so much. Chef has made garlic rice for us. Hot,
it
hot.
It smells so good.
Yeah, it does.
I always smell my food like.
So we are going to dig into our garlic rice.
Yeah, that's good.
Have you tried this last time when you were here?
No, I didn't have the rice. I have not tried the rice. Watch me struggle with this.
All right.
Let's
I also can't do this. So shall we just take a break? then we can just easily eat this.
And it's steaming. Okay. It's so hot.
Ikote is where we are. You can always check this place out. It's located at the Dutch Hospital. It's beautiful. It's brilliant food. We will see you on the other side with more right here on Double on Fire on High TV. Having such a good time right here on Dad on Fire with this beauty. At least through such shows, I get to go on such beautiful dates.
Oh, Dado, we can go on dates at any time.
Thanks. That's a charity cause.
Oh my God, no. No, I love hanging out. It's been fun. It's been super fun.
We did a radio show together. That was fun too.
We did, yeah.
I know. That was right after your crowning.
One before one.
Before and after, yes. All right. So now that we've spoken about your pageant and the whole drama, now, tell me, you got this name right, the dessert that we're having?
Yes.
What is it called?
Strawberry Daifuku.
Strawberry Daifuku. Got it.
I hope I'm saying it right.
Must be. Sounds right.
Let's try it.
All right, let's dig in.
Okay. Let's try it. You go first.
I'm going to
Are you an ice cream person?
Oh, I love,
you love ice cream?
I love ice cream, cheese. These are my weaknesses.
It's like butterscotch. Why strawberry? Maybe this?
I've already spilled. That's so good.
Don't worry.
These sound really bad.
Imagine
the audio
wait,
is
good. It's this is interesting.
It's like rubbery.
Interesting, yeah. Oh,
is it meant to be?
I don't know.
Taken off this plate. Okay, I've got somewhere.
Yeah, you go for it first. Let me see. This is difficult.
All my gym workout is helping me on this.
I see the strawberry. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I'm gonna take like an hour to get to it. Hold on.
Oh my God, you should try.
Yeah, I'm getting there. Hold on.
Oh my God, that's so good.
Okay.
Oh, this is really good.
Ah, there's a strawberry in the middle.
Can I break it for you?
Yes, please.
No, you have broken it.
No, but then you have to go this way again, right? Otherwise, it's too big.
Really? Give all you three.
Thank you, Donna. I'm just picturing. Yeah.
Now, this whole food review business, how did you get into it? Like, did you ever think that it'll become...
Thank you.
I know you started putting up pictures, but now that like hotels book you and...
Yeah.
Do you like it? Have you ever thought...
I mean, I love it. I love it. And initially I started, it was a hobby. I didn't think of it as... Oh yeah, sorry. Being a profession.
Yeah.
So if I eat, I can't talk.
Oh, sorry. First eat, you know, I'll wait till they're done.
Okay. See,
I cut two pieces
Yeah,
for you.
But there's a... Okay, hold on.
That's an edible flower. Okay, go. Isn't it nice? It's not worthy of a comment. Just let it, just enjoy it. It's so good. Now tell me, will you? Okay.
Okay, I need a minute. Okay.
So this whole...
Okay. So like I said, I love food. So initially started with me going to restaurants and stuff.
Yeah, and you were just posting things.
Yeah, just documenting it.
Yeah.
Guys, I love this restaurant, this place. And then initially started off being a hobby. And then when I realized so many... That was a gap in the market at the time, you know, but nowadays
you
bloggers
started a long time ago.
Long time, 3 years.
Okay, but at that time, Instagram was not so big as it is right now.
Yeah, exactly. But now you have like bloggers and it popping every night, you know.
Yeah.
So yeah, when I started off, it was just as a hobby. And then so many people kept inviting me, we need this done, and it became more of like a job. So I was like, then I'm going to turn it into a profession and, you know, just do it professionally.
So
I love it.
But right now you go for a review practically every other day.
Pretty much. I at least have 2 a week.
When you started seeing followers, you know, you can even buy followers today.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But it's pointless. I always say, I do not appeal to not all the whole of Sri Lanka. So it's pointless me trying to say, okay, I have followers in Poland, Narua. It doesn't benefit my clients.
Right.
So like that, you, of course, now when you reach out to your clients, know exactly where they're coming to.
Yeah. So there'll be days, sometimes I get 100 followers in like 2 days just because of the post I uploaded. So those are genuine followers. So I think people need to take it more seriously.
Yeah.
It's not just the number that's on a profile. It has to be authentic.
Yeah,
know?
And also the fact that people are interacting, they're talking
exactly.
to you.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. And when they see something that you're doing, that they want to be a part of it.
Yeah. Yeah.
So in terms of this whole world of beauty, you're not in the scene, but what do you think is one thing that Miss Universe has taught you?
Okay. It has taught me a lot of things. And before I went for Miss Universe, I lacked a lot of self-confidence. I went into it not knowing like, oh, I'm going to be surrounded with all this beauty. And you know, there were days when I was at the pageant where I was like, am I good enough? Am I good enough to represent my country? And I had to pick myself up, because if I spoke to my family about it, they're going to say like, no, you're amazing,
yeah,
you know?
Because they love you so much.
Of course. So it was something I had to do by myself, like talk to myself every day, be like, I am worth it and I am good enough.
Yeah.
And this is something that helped me a lot even now, because before I couldn't stand up for myself. If someone were to say you did this or you did that, and I would be like, yeah, like I would just like back off from it. Yeah,
but now you're like, listen,
I have so much confidence in myself.
But you have looked up to your dad to fill in the gap of your mom and also your sister.
Yeah,
tell me about losing your mom and how was it to sort of keep everything together.
I was 13 at the time, and then I wasn't very vocal about it and I wasn't open about it, because I thought there were people online who thought I would want attention from it. But then when I started, like Miss Universe was a platform I was able to speak about it. That was my video, you know? And I had so many young girls approach me and message me saying, I lost my dad or my mom and watching your video made me strong. I want to be like you one day. And I was like, I need to speak about it more, because it helps someone else.
Of course.
Yeah, so before I couldn't speak, but now
I'm like. And also, it's amazing how your dad sort of picked up the pieces.
Yeah, my dad is amazing.
And ran with the two girls, and, you know, to see him sit back and see y'all grow up and do things that y'all are meant to do.
I mean, there are times he's just like, you know, we just give him a panic attack from time to time.
No,
he was growing up, my dad was very strict. He was super strict.
But now he has to fill two shoes. So.
I know. Yeah. But now he's more lenient with us, because he knows now we're big girls.
Yeah, so he gives that.
He really stepped it up.
Yeah, but I have to say, I met her dad and sister when she was crowned. It was such a beautiful experience to know the
cried.
Bond. I know. And the bond that they had. It was like he was actually walking into the altar. Like, oh my God, she just got married.
I know,
but
I know.
It's amazing though that you all have such a connection. Mm. Kristen, I'm so happy that you came on the show.
Thank you for having me.
She gave me like pink dotted dates that she's free, and we've been trying to do this for a long time.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah,
I'm so
happy you're here, and I would love to see more of you on Hi TV, and for you to do greater things in life and live, look beautiful and just enjoy life.
Thank you, Danu. Thank you for having me. I had so much fun and I'm so full right now. Kind of.
That's the best part. That's the best date, I tell you. Yes. We need to say a big thank you to the restaurant for hosting us, giving the hospitality that is always so warm and so friendly. I'm telling you, when it's something from Hilton, you always feel that. Big shout out to our friends who have made this show possible, LICC Jeans. Big thank you to the crew that's here for making this show possible. Until I see you with another brilliant episode.